This is the BBC Home Service presenting...
And beautifully preserved, too.
Yes, that's because we always keep it under glass.
I see. Mr. Greenstein, I've just noticed. Do you always do your announcing without any clothes on?
No, but this is a special occasion. Tonight is John Snagg's coming out party. Oh. His mother's throwing a ball.
Who's betting?
Well, if you must know, a fiend Chinaman called Emperor of the Universe.
I see. That sounds sinister.
Yes. Now, put on this black tilby with a zip front, release these racing vultures, and prepare yourself to take part in Bulldog Seagoon's first case entitled...
Gad, Algy, it's a dark, dank October evening in London.
Yes, Bulldog. And the thick fog is swirling against the window panes of your apartment overlooking the River Thames in London, lighting up time 6:40 p.m.
High tide, 3:12. Yes, Algernon. And here on the walls of my study at 11 Sussex Gardens
yes?
are the fruits of 80 years globe-trotting and rug-making.
Yes, indeed, Bulldog. And standing there... in your Norfolk jacket and drawers. You must be terribly, terribly proud of your collection of weapons.
Jove, indeed, Algernon. As I draw casually on my pipe, letting a luxuriant wisp of smoke escape from the bowl.
Really?
I insert a fresh wisp and say, yes, there you see the Gurkha kukri. Kukri. It's a kukri book. This is the Zulu assegai.
An assegai who done it.
Happy. I don't wish to know that, Algernon. Up here on the floor, the Prussian saber, and there, Algernon.
Here, he clenched his lips, and the knuckles show white to the ears on his skin.
Yes, Algernon. There we have surely the most dreaded weapon of all, the British rolled newspaper.
Yes, indeed, sir. An awesome sight, Bulldog.
True, Algy, true. These lumps in my head could tell a tale.
Then why don't they?
I've sworn them to silence.
Well, cheers and spoken word.
Needle, noddle, no.
More devilish brandy, sir.
Just a chota pint.
Right. Milk and sugar?
Please. One sugar and two milks. I'm on the water wagon, you know.
I wondered why you look so tall.
I'm driving. I say.
Yes?
I say, afternoon. I say, have you seen this rather interesting item in the Times? Government officials are concerned by the alarming decrease in the number of Englishmen per capita.
Good heavens, Bulldog. This is right up your street.
Yes, that's why I live here.
Really?
Oh, heavens. Yes. Well, I wouldn't be surprised at all if even as I speak, I received a phone call from the government. Just a moment, I've not done yet. From the government. There they are now. Hello? It's a Spawn 3829.
Is that Mingley 0607?
No, this is,
What is the number?
I've just read it. This is... Nurglen. Oh.
Have you hurt yourself?
Only in the past.
And the best time to do it, too. I'm speaking for the Foreign Secretary. He's having his teeth repaired.
Really? You should have had them lagged this weather.
Listen, Bulldodge. It's regarding the missing Englishman. Can you come over here right away?
Certainly. Hello?
Goodbye.
Algy, tell the chauffeur to drive my boots round.
Wouldn't plimsolls be faster, sir?
Of course. Hurry.
Right.
On the Foreign Office door. Just thought I'd let you know where I was, folks. As I entered the Foreign Secretary's office, I became aware of a distinguished white face peering down from the top of an airing cupboard.
Morning. Sit down.
Sit down, huh? The plot thickens.
Yes. Bulldog, have a bus ticket.
Well, just a tuppenny one. Mmm. Delicious.
Yes, they're hand-punched, you know.
I might have guessed. My father smoked Fortneys. They go further.
Oh, oh, kill brilliant grass bubble up.
Keep quiet in there, Moriarty.
Now, Bulldog, you've heard about this mysterious disappearance of Englishmen. In 1 year, 25 million have vanished.
England is short of Englishmen?
Desperately.
Are Welshmen short, too?
Just look at you.
Duck's disease, the curse of the seagull.
Yes, it must be hell down there.
It is.
There, there, there. Have another bus ticket, please.
No, 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 you have one of mine.
Oh, thank you. If you don't mind, I'll clip it later.
Of course. Now, this shortage of Englishmen, is it having repercussions?
Is it? Do you know what gilt-edged Englishmen are fetching on the stock exchange? £50 a piece.
Who's paying £50 a piece for Englishmen?
English women. Depending on the piece thereafter, of course. Please don't do that with your head on. It spoils the view.
How can I help England in its darkest hour?
Turn on your radio and I'll tell you.
Now, Bulldog, solve this mystery and we'll pay you a fee of 2 long green things with nails in the end.
At last! A fortune in long green things with nails in the end! I'll commence investigations immediately. Goodbye!
All right, Moriarty, he's gone. You can come out of that fountain pen now.
I nearly drowned in there.
I'm sorry, Moriarty. I refilled the pen without thinking. Take a message.
Right.
No, don't use a typewriter. You might be overheard.
Right. I'll use a saw. Then no one will saw it except me.
It's bad English, but a good excuse.
Thank you.
Now, saw out this address and don't fret. It's,
Triumph of writing books.
Hell, sparkling dialogue, Maria. Address it to Mr. Emperor of the Universe. Disappearing Englishman causing government to be suspicious.
Not too fast, not too fast.
Have succeeded in putting a right Charlie on the job. Assure you he is too stupid to discover anything. Sign, Gritpipe Thine, Acting Foreign Secretary.
How do you spell that?
Give me that saw. GRYTPIPETHYNNE. P.S. Find enclosed 1 Max Gilbert.
Let's get on.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.